Howdy, Paul Acevedo, EastX Twitch here from Windows Central. Tonight I am joined on the mic by Brian.
Hello.
So-called gamer, also known as Jeff.
How's it going?
Royal Bob.
Howdy.
Derek Kuda.
Hello, hello.
And that's everybody, although we also have WestX in the room. He's just not on mic. This is a very special stream. I'll go over it, even though you might have already heard. We are streaming the English Xbox One version of Onigiri. Onigiri is a Japanese massively multiplayer online role-playing game. It is already out in Japan on Xbox One. However, the English versions, other than the PC version, are not out yet. Like this, although some people have been able to download this game, they cannot actually play it yet, because it is not open to the public. It is still in the testing phase, and we're very fortunate, thanks to the cooperation of CyberStep, to be able to play this game all on our own, just our team, in this massively multiplayer game. It's pretty cool. So it's a little bit of a ghost town. The real game will have a lot more players. It's free to play. Everybody will be able to just download it and play. There will be lots of people, but right now it's just us, and that's cool in its own way, just to be able to experience the game for ourselves before everybody else, and share that with you. Oh, hey, there's Zero on Twitch. He's here. I see X-Hobo.
No, you cannot play it right now, even if you have it.
Yeah, unfortunately.
You can play the Japanese version if you
could
have
do that.
It. Just not the English one.
Yeah, but don't worry. It can't be that far off if they're allowing us to do this testing and share it with you guys. Like, I expect it's within 1 or 2 months of release. And we'll be sure to update our audience at WindowsCentral.com when we have a firm release date. So here we're starting in the main town of Onigashima. This is an MMO hub world. You've got some NPCs here who will give you quests and explain the story to you. Let's talk to Lady Shizuka, who is the first AI companion that you get. I'm kind of inadvertently rolling. Why does he keep doing that?
If you double tap in any direction, you roll.
Actually, if you just quick tap in any direction.
Yeah, it looks like even a quick tap will do it. It takes a little getting used to, that's okay.
Yeah, I struggled with it a lot at first, but now it's not a problem.
So you start out, you get an AI companion, so even if you're not in a party, you'll always have at least one companion with you, as long as you don't... Don't they use kind of an energy system of some sort? Yes.
Yeah. And then once they die, you have to wait a while before you can use them again.
So what kind of present do I give her? What is she like? You can raise your friendship level with these partners.
If you check check the description of the present, and they tell you which
one. Oh, yeah, greatly. All right, so I'm going to give her a present, just see what that looks like.
Yeah, give her the pendant.
Cannot give present because it is registered as a favorite. What does that even mean, guys?
Oh, uncheck the box.
Yeah.
Whoops. All right. There we go. Did it give it to her? Yeah.
I guess it's so tall.
If you're... Number went down.
Yeah, it did go down. And what could I do?
Then you gave one.
So, anyway, I'm going to close that up. I'm going to join a party with my pals here. Let's see, where are you guys? So one person is the party leader, obviously, and that is going to be so-called gamer. To interact with... Camera angle is going a little weird here. How do I zoom back out, guys? There we go. It was just the angle.
Left click, or click on the right stick.
Yeah, so push start. Or the menu button, and this allows you to access character menus and things like that. You can check on quests. There's a bestiary, a bunch of social things. You can blacklist players if there's somebody you don't like. And now I'm going to join this party. Join this party, yes. What are the benefits?
I was about to say, maybe I should stop moving around.
Yeah, I got it. Is everyone who is joining the party in the party already?
Yep. All right.
Yeah, I could see.
Five of us total?
Yes.
Yeah, there you guys are. I can see all their life meters on the left side of the screen. All right. Now, remember, given that I'm only level 3, we need to venture out and do some low-level questing things, right? Let's get me up a little.
Yep. Yeah, we could probably do anything like 5, 6, 7. We could
There's a training grounds over here, too, that you probably still have to do.
Training ground?
Yep.
It's just like a dungeon.
Okay. That's can we do it as a group?
Yeah, yep. Definitely.
So it's downstairs one level? Alright, let's go over there and do that.
It's the,
Zero, be nice. Let me talk to this NPC, Tetsumaru. This game is based on Japanese mythology, so the characters we're playing are called Oni, I believe.
Yep.
Yep.
Monsters.
Give it up, even I couldn't defeat it. The text animation for the dialogue appearing, it's pretty good, I think.
I really like the enemy design in this game a lot.
Yeah, there's a lot of Japanese mythology, Kappa, and all kinds of stuff.
Those are good things. Alright, okay, I have accepted that quest, and now who has to choose the dungeon that we're going into? You, so-called?
Anyone can.
Right, I'll go.
Yeah,
I think you should run in there.
Let's do it, and then suggested level 4, or should I pick a higher one?
Oh, she's mad at me and won't let me in.
Let's do the lowest level first, just to get started. Yeah, this is an instanced dungeon, so if other people were playing online right now, we would still only see the people in our party. Yeah, and by the way, the reason that we don't have some of our regular co-hosts on mic is because we already have a lot of people on mic who are participating in the game, and so we don't need to confuse things with extra people.
Well, you don't want to have 10 people?
I guess not. Here, I'm fighting an enemy called a Daruma. This is actually a traditional Japanese doll based on a Buddhist monk, a famous Buddhist monk, and I guess they've turned it into a bad guy.
And just to let you guys know, the loot system, basically everyone gets their own separate loot. Different stuff appears on everyone's screen.
It's fine with me.
I must have been too far away from you guys, because you didn't bring me with
Ryan.
You.
It doesn't. You have to just walk in and then select the level.
Oh, okay.
Which kind of a funny story. I was doing the easiest
difficulty.
Okay.
I'll be there shortly.
So kind of a funny story. I was doing one the other day, and So-Called was in my party. And I just killed the boss, and So-Called's like, wow, I'm getting experience. I'm not even near you. And then I look behind me, and So-Called's like coming up the ramp at the end of the dungeon.
Yeah, we didn't even know we were going to the same place.
Yeah, we just kind of happened to be there.
So right trigger is the main attack button, and left trigger uses skills.
Yep.
Yes.
Yep, and Y targets the character.
There we go. He's targeted.
Yeah. And if you hit Y again, it goes to the next enemy.
Actually, didn't know about the Y thing.
Yeah, the game teaches you a few of the controls, but it does not teach you all the buttons, which is a little unintuitive. But...
And you click in your left stick to block.
And there is an achievement for blocking 1,000 times. In the Japanese version, I just grinded that out like real early on in the starting field.
Yeah, it's really helpful for some of the bosses.
I can't even imagine doing that.
Well, I think I just had to stand there holding the left stick just for like half an hour, I believe.
I have fallen through the map and I'm coming back to you guys now.
Hurry back.
Oh my.
Yeah. Welcome to the stream, everybody. You know, we haven't done a midweek stream in several weeks because things have been hectic. You know, I was in Europe just last week, and, you know, prior to that, I had a lot of preparation to do for the trip, and, you know, plus I'm just always behind on writing and different things.
Yeah, plus we're trying to avoid Adam.
Definitely that.
Almost worked.
Looks like Minecraft. What are you talking about, Tyler?
Oh, that's cool, Tyler.
This doesn't look like Minecraft.
We did address, yes, it is a graphically simplistic game. And so that's going to keep some people away, even if they didn't, you know, even if they didn't mind the Japanese-style imagery or whatever. But...
I thought it had a very Dreamcast feel to it. Actually, really
exactly,
enjoyed
dude. Same here.
Oh.
Like, I almost put Dreamcast in my article, but then I didn't want the reference to be too obscure.
I think it's, and you kind of mentioned this earlier, it has roughly, I mean, it's better graphics, but roughly the same sort of look as Phantasy Star Online. So you automatically think Dreamcast.
Yeah, and even the combat is a little Phantasy Star Online-like. Not the same, but a little bit like it.
I like how everything's fully voice over too, or almost
all the big
everything.
Cinemas, yeah. Japanese voices with English subtitles, right?
Yeah, yep. Even the just talking to NPCs.
Oh, really?
So I'll have voiceovers.
Yeah, unfortunately, yeah. I've got my audio off right now, so I'm not able to hear it.
I like yeah. that. I just wish the subtitles would move a little slower.
I guess the characters are talking too fast.
Yeah, there are some times where the characters will over, like, they'll talk over each other very often. It's kind of funny.
Yeah, it's just timing. They'll work it out.
Yeah, I like it.
So yeah, Paul, as far as the person I summon, you should come check out the person next to me.
Oh, yeah.
I'll have to do that. I believe...
She has a tail.
I believe the crew is referencing... Oh, oh, yeah, is this the revealing character lady? Yeah, she's very revealingly dressed. Woo!
But she's a cat, so it's
there
okay.
There you go.
Yeah, oh, yeah, totally. She's totally not a person.
The game has some revealing character art, and that's either a plus or minus, depending on how you look at things. Personally, you know... I choose to embrace it. I usually err towards political correctness, but you have to remember that Japanese culture is different from ours.
Minor spoiler alert, they do discuss, she has an argument with another character about her revealing clothes.
Oh yeah?
And I sided with the cat lady in the argument.
So Bob Jones asks, can the info stuff be hidden? If you're talking about like the help stuff, that's only there because it's the first dungeon. If you're talking about everything else is there for good. I mean, it's kind of what MMO looks like.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's no real settings for the game yet. Mostly just audio.
Oh, and here we are at a boss, aren't we? Big skeleton dude.
I really like the artwork, too. And the loading screens.
It's nice.
And the, when they show the bosses.
Yep.
I'm gonna hang back so I don't kill this guy in like
sure.
2 minutes.
Zero capture card? No. I think, wasn't Zero's issue with streaming that he doesn't have enough upload bandwidth because of, you know, living in Canada where they use...
I mean, he can barely watch our streams.
Yeah, I mean, in Canada they use strings and cups connected to each other by string for the internet, so it's...
Oh, that's messed up.
It's unfortunate.
It's old tuna cans.
Oh,
get it right.
So this guy is surprisingly tough, but I wonder if they scale it based on the number of people.
I can switch to items.
Hey, how are you doing, Windor?
We're not really doing anything.
Welcome,
Windor. Guy.
Are you saying I should?
Yeah, you might as well. We don't need to be fighting
yeah,
too long.
We're...
What's that one-shot kill?
Yeah. Die, punk. Yeah, I wish the using items tutorial would go away.
Yeah, you can item him.
There you go, he's dead.
Woo!
But using items is very important, oh, so maybe that's why they focus
so
on
so-called
it.
Smoked him.
Oh wow, there's a lot of loot.
Yeah, yeah. Dungeon clear.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it scales, because there's a way more loot than when I did this like 10 minutes ago.
We got an SS ranking.
Yeah, as far as loot's concerned, all gold and stuff you pretty much automatically pick up. All the other stuff you actually have to hit a button to pick up, but you don't have to be like super precise. You just run over and hit the button.
That's a good thing.
And to get an FF,
you just
right. Now
you.
We just exit.
To get FF, you don't die, so it's not too difficult.
Go team. There's a bunch of us. Because we've.
But you can still die and use an item. Ah. That'll be fine.
Aw, don't say that, Zero.
I was about to tell him.
Hey,
correct.
He's my favorite Canadian. got a little story cinematic going on.
Yep. And it's weird because if it's your first time seeing it, you can't skip it when you're in a party. Even though people that have already seen it don't have to watch it.
The rest of the party just kind of wonders what you're doing as you're standing
yeah.
still.
Yeah, the first time we did this one with so-called, it's kind of like, why are you standing uh-huh. there?
Dangerous.
You can't hold A to skip the dialogue faster if you don't
gotcha.
Want to watch it.
Are you sure it's not the right bumper?
To do what?
To zip through the dialogue.
Could be both.
It's either. You can do A or right bumper.
So we sealed this thing off.
Yeah.
Let's return to Edo.
Make sure you click on it, actually. Seal it.
I'm not going back. What's everybody drinking tonight? I'm having a Diet Monster.
Coke Zero.
Good stuff.
Miller Lite.
Yeah. Generic.
I had a Dos Equis, but no,
dude,
I'm
Miller
Lite
sounds good.
Yeah.
I had about a quarter gallon of chocolate milk before
that
one.
Wow. Impressive.
It was darn tasty.
Yeah, we don't have a specific release date yet. We addressed that a little bit earlier. But you can be assured that the announcement of the English release date for the console versions of Onigiri will come through Windows Central.
See ya, bums.
Miss you, bums.
Okay, so after that dungeon we did, something should have popped up on your screen about getting soul eggs. Like an achievement type thing.
Oh man, you know this dialogue is actually entertaining, but yeah, that's the problem. We're on a stream and I've got people waiting on me.
Yeah.
But it's pretty well written. So better than you would expect.
For doing certain things, you'll get achievements, and they don't automatically. You get rewards for them too, like in-game achievements, and they show up in the present section of the menu.
Ooh.
So you have to go to press start, go to system, and then presence, and you should have a bunch of
stuff.
Let's
have a
look.
Start, system, presence.
If Revolver Ocelot has large anime boobs, then totally he's in this game. Zero.
There you go. I've got a soul egg. What is a soul egg? No, I've got 20 of those.
Refresh your screen, Windork.
You use the soul egg to revive without using a life that affects your rating.
Gotcha.
So if you use a soul egg, you can still get an SS.
That's good.
Right.
I like that we have a rating like that. It encourages some replay value. Let's leave the dungeon.
My first thought was the ratings on Dance Dance Revolution. That's kind of what reminded me of.
Exhobo's asking about when the Japanese version will be updated to raise the level cap to 100. And if anybody reminds me, I can be sure to ask Cyberstep that when I'm talking to them.
I saw there was an achievement for getting to level 100, but I guess it's just unobtainable now.
Wait. Oh, no, I think he means exceeding level 100.
Oh, okay.
Who's driving Zero crazy, it seems. Alright, that was a good dungeon. Do we want to do a harder one, or do we want to move on to a different area?
Probably move. Like, there's another dungeon right outside.
Okay, let's go to that one.
That's probably good.
Let's go fight the giant crab.
Yeah, I want to see that crab.
I like that guy, but...
Did you just go up 3 levels in that one dungeon?
Yeah,
four?
I'm level 7 now, so yeah.
I think I killed that boss, the skeleton boss, the first time, and I jumped like 5.
Oh yeah, make sure you press start, go to my character, and then status to equip your skill points.
Yeah, make sure you distribute those.
Let's go do that.
Oh yeah, because last night when we were playing, I had like 36.
I was wondering why Derek was like losing at this one boss, and then it turned out he had a ton of skill points.
Yeah, I got on today and I had 41.
Nice.
Yeah, there were some issues last night, but they fixed it very quickly, and I was really impressed.
If you're using Edge still has some problems, Windork.
Unfortunately. Alright, coming. Let's go.
Yeah, it makes you feel pretty good when the developer fixes a rather large issue for like 3 people and does it the same day.
Yeah, they're taking this game seriously, and they've been so helpful and cooperative with setting up this preview, you know, and all of our English language coverage for the game. They're allowing Windows Central to lead the way on that, and that's just a really special opportunity for us, so we're extremely grateful. Hopefully you guys enjoy having someone to communicate this with you too, because often, like with a smaller Japanese or Asian developer and publisher, there just wouldn't be a source for the English news other than maybe like their Facebook page. But no, you know, because we've cultivated this relationship, we're able to show you the game in English early, you know, and that's great.
So C. Griffiths wants us to ask them, or wants you to ask them, if officially licensed body pillows will be available.
Oh man, we gotta find that out, right?
That's actually not a bad idea.
This is the starting field. This is where you go just to build up a little bit, and you can work on some quests. Like, there's a quest for killing, you know, X number of these guys, etc.
And these guys spawn really quick.
Whoa.
Yeah,
fast. NPCs are spawning.
Where'd that big guy go?
Yeah, don't attack
crap.
That thing with the eyes.
He killed me.
Unless
he killed
you're
me.
Level.
Oh, yeah, I'm a high enough level, I still can't even... him.
He's level
I've
30.
Never seen him before. I just yeah. I wanted to pound
I,
on him.
I have a 33 character and I just
okay, I revive
oh,
him.
Wow.
So is he
I made that guy mad.
He must only be appearing because uh-oh. You guys are pretty high level, I guess.
No,
he's
was
always
appearing
okay,
because
I've never seen him before.
Yeah.
He's scary.
Yeah, there's only one of him in the area though, so
basically he's a one hit kill.
Watch out for that dude.
Yeah, he fell on me and killed me earlier.
I tried fighting him last night before I realized he was such a high level, and I was like, why aren't I doing any damage?
Does Adam say that he has a...
That took about 20 minutes.
For some reason, Adam is saying that he has an open cold sword. We don't really have to know that, Adam.
So if you, get, if you have a pink arrow, it's kind of like a random event that is the quest that it gives you automatically.
I did not know that. Yeah.
Usually it's like kill a few enemies.
Blue arrows are side quests, right? And yellow are story quests? Or not yellow, but orange.
Yes. Well, the orange is you've completed a mission and you have to go back to get the reward or whatever.
Yeah, I can do that another time.
Yeah, good experience.
Tyler, I already know the answer to that. Dragon Quest Heroes is going to be extremely cool. And speaking of, Dragon Quest Heroes is a Warriors game with, you know, based on the Dragon Quest series, right? Well, I just, this week, a new Warriors game came out in America, and that is One Piece Warriors 3, I think is what it's called? Something like that. You know, it's based on One Piece, but it is a Dynasty Warriors, Samurai Warriors type game. And I just got that for the Vita to stream, so I think next week we'll be streaming that midweek at some point.
Did you just tell me there's going to be another Dynasty Warriors game?
Dude, there's a lot of them. No, but this one just came out called, you know, it's based on the anime One Piece. And I'm not, like, especially familiar with One Piece, you know, but I like anime in general. And I also hear that the One Piece ones are some of the best ones that they make, you know. So we'll see if that's true or not.
So we're gonna do a dungeon and just slaughter everything in this area.
We're gonna hunt them to extinction.
Nice to
I'm building up a lot of gold.
Yeah, level 9 now.
Yeah.
We can just hop in here.
Oh crap! I just took a lot of damage.
Can't remember.
I gotta remember to heal.
Which one do we want to do? 7, 11, or 18?
7.
We should probably do 11.
Fine.
11 or 7?
11.
Let's do 11.
Alright. Oh yeah, we should have rolled 9s.
So we're doing the 11?
Looks that way.
Yeah.
Okay.
Tyler, you gotta embrace your grinding side. You know, like, Tyler always just wants to rush through these short little games. He doesn't like to stop and enjoy any one particular game unless it's Spelunky. But...
Well, to be perfectly honest, we haven't done really much grinding in this game at all.
Yeah, there's like no grinding at all.
Especially if you're used to other MMOs, there's next to none so far. Well, there was one side mission that was grinding. That's it.
Sounds good to me. All right, I'm increasing my vitality because I find that I don't have enough life. Although, really, I probably need better stuff equipped, better Magatamas and what have you.
Yeah, try to just avoid getting hit by last off. These guys are level 13 also. So what I think happens is, so we kill a guy, we get experience for it, but then the same amount of experience also goes to like a separate pool. And once we complete the dungeon, we get all that experience. So it's kind of like getting double XP.
Bob Jones asks if there's end game content.
You know,
not really there yet.
Don't know yet.
Maybe we have 33, and it's still looks like there's a lot left. I mean, the level 100's end game, I think.
Yeah. So.
Yeah, most of us are pretty new to this game.
It's Japanese, so there's probably Onigiri in here somewhere.
The rice balls.
Yeah,
Inverted Access wants to know if it's on PS4 as well,
Or yeah, it will be, I believe, Paul's
yes,
article
it
said.
Is coming to PlayStation 4, and, you know, everything I wrote in today's preview applies to that version as well as this one. The only thing release date-wise, I promised that we would announce release dates, right? Well, we're announcing the release date for the Xbox One version. We are not going to be announcing the release date for the PlayStation 4 version. We worked that out as a deal.
Sounds fair enough. It's not like anyone in the chat room cares about PlayStation anyways.
No. In fact, I have it on good authority that our viewers hate PlayStation systems, so...
Hey now.
Especially inverted access. Yes.
He totally wasn't kicked off Xbox Live for doing naughty things. Totally.
Not at all.
Well, we could always hear that story for 100 times.
Yeah, it never gets old. No.
Totally. Yeah, don't be shy about using your healing items, because so you can buy them from your PC later on.
How do you do
the
Sisu things in the lower right corner, huh?
The first three, the three leftmost ones are HP, and the two right are mana.
Going through the door? Alright.
Yep.
Gotcha. Poor Tyler, he got screwed.
You did not. You tried to game the system and they caught you.
Yeah.
Don't lie.
Yeah, now we all love Tyler, of course, you know, despite his inverted genitalia. But he did do something wrong. We caught up with him.
So when you see these guys jump up in the air, their duck does backdash away until they land. They do a lot of damage, especially later on.
Yeah, basically any character that jumps and lands on you,
sort of
is
like a one
doing
kill.
Serious damage. Yeah.
Run.
Yeah, it's like those triple guys, there's a good chance they'll kill you on one hit, but they do like three jumps.
It's easy to avoid, but you just gotta make sure you actually do it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, that, no, believe me, we all know that it sucks, Tyler, you know. And, you know, I mean, it was a bad thing, but I've done bad things, you know, and I don't always get caught for them.
I mean, like, less than 1% of people who speed on the highway get caught.
We all make our, but, you know, you don't think of it as a mistake until you get caught, right? But we all do things that could easily turn into mistakes.
Well, the mistake is getting caught.
You shouldn't speed when you're right next to a trooper.
That too. Well, you gotta have a radar detector if you're gonna be a speeder.
Stick to 5 over and you'll be fine.
Well, true, but that's scarcely even speeding, dude.
Yeah.
Unless you meet that really mean cop who just...
He's gotta be having a bad day.
Really has it out for you.
Well, that's true.
After this dungeon, make sure you repair your weapon. You should probably get new weapons, actually.
Who? Do I have the repair person yet? Is it the lady we just got, Yoshitsune?
No. It's the seller, the one with the mask on his...
No, it's the girl he met at the other...
Oh, no, you're right.
The girl Yoshitsune?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm actually really impressed with the funding scale. I didn't think they did when we were playing earlier.
They might have changed it.
Yeah, I think so.
Wow, this is sort of getting a little crazy here.
So this reminds me of that one Vita game that you were playing with Tyler.
Tokiden?
Yes.
Yeah, they are both steeped in Japanese mythology. So that's pretty cool. Tokiden definitely has tighter and more complex combat, but you know, that's okay. This one has a wonderful sense of scale and the fact that you can play with bunches of people. Looks like we're climbing up. Where are we climbing to?
Yes. Oh, there's two bots. All right. Normally, when you fight this, there's only one boss.
Todaiki.
Really,
that's kind of like the word Tokiden, isn't it? I'm gonna change weapons. How do you do that? Let's see. Up and down. Do I have a long range gun? Well, I can use a spear. I'll use a spear for a little bit. I mentioned this in the preview, but you can carry around a bunch of weapons at once and switch between them at will with up and down on the D-pad. That is handy. You can. You don't have to just be melee or just range, you know, you can hop back and forth between them.
It's kind of necessary later on, because
good job, team.
They break very easily.
Yeah, I was in a dungeon yesterday that I think I went through like 5 different weapons.
But to be fair, he was severely underleveled for that dungeon.
True.
There was a lot of swearing and cursing.
Yeah.
Never.
Leave this dungeon.
Let's blow this popsicle.
And I understand there is at least one achievement for completing like 200 dungeons or something, you know, like for completing a lot.
We get the S ranks.
I hope you guys couldn't hear that. My cat just like had a stroke in a chair behind me.
Poor kitty.
She's playing.
Yeah, Bob Jones, everything's running smooth on my end. So I'm watching the stream as well.
It's not so silky smooth for me. As far as like the game is concerned, it's kind of janky.
I'm talking about the actual stream video.
Yeah, well, the stream seems fine to me. I have it up in the background.
Ooh, I got a new Magatama. Now I can equip it.
Yep, too.
Alright, let's do that. My character.
Yeah, it's kind of nice also. The dungeon, they encourage you to finish them because they put most of the experience in what they call experience pool. And you don't get that experience until you actually complete the dungeon. So if you go through like 3/4 of it, don't complete it, and leave it, you don't get most of the experience.
And remember to check your present section, because that's where one of the Magatamas went.
Also, check your status points, because I only went up 3 levels recently, and I already have 52 points.
An enemy just flew through my body. That was weird looking.
Yeah, every 10 levels you get a bonus of status points.
And do you guys like to mix your stat points around, or are you doing, how are you doing it?
I pretty much keep it the same proportions as the character started at.
Yeah, me too.
I just put points in what I think I want.
Yeah, each of these stats obviously has different benefits. Like some will affect how fast your SP charges up, which fuels blocking and using abilities.
Yeah, once you get a higher level, it's your SP is not really. Like, I know it's a lower level, you can use it up really fast, but once you level up more, it's not a problem at all.
I would say this game is a lot less. How to describe it? It's lot less dependent on you being a specific class compared to a lot of MMOs.
Yeah, I don't think there's like a specific healer class either.
I like that flexibility. Although I guess if you really got into specific roles, then maybe you'd be like, this doesn't let me tank enough or something. I don't know.
So yeah, there definitely isn't the whole tank DPS healer setup that you would see in some MMOs.
I'm gonna go turn this in real quick. Yeah, you know, C. Griffiths mentions that the UI is a little odd. You have to remember, C. Griffiths, that this is a direct port of a PC game, and so they haven't really changed anything. It is just like the PC game, but the menu controls, again, they take some getting used to, but personally I am used to them, so they don't bother me.
Yeah, I played it for like 12 hours yesterday. I'm used to it,
and it actually functions really well even with the layout.
Yeah, if you were to look at Final Fantasy 14, which is probably the second largest MMO out there. It's on PC and PlayStation, and the UIs are basically the same. So it doesn't really need to be changed that much. It's just how you go from element to element, really, using
Make
the controller.
Sure you identify the items you got from the cave, and that will give you new weapons, because the weapons you have now are probably pretty close to breaking.
The pink-haired girl is the one who does that.
Shizuka?
Yes,
I'm terrible with names in real life and in video games.
I know there's Cat Lady, the Naganada guy, and the guy that looks like it's Zoro's Wrath. They're my 3 favorites.
You know, I really liked Zoro's Wrath when I was playing it. I reviewed it at Co-Optimus a long time ago. You know, for one of their single, they have non-co-op reviews as well. But I got to a boss that was just way too hard, and that was the last time I played the game. It's like I was having so much fun until I think it was chapter 15 or something. Let's see, turn this
down. I like the boss from that because it was really
they were epic, dude. But yeah, this one boss, I don't know, I tried him like 5 or 6 times, and that was enough for me.
Yeah, some of the bosses are ridiculously hard. But I like it, I like that style.
I know, whenever I'm like, this game is too hard, then Bob's like, I want to play that.
Yeah, exactly.
Freaking masochist.
That's why I like this game, because there's... It feels like you can actually dodge attacks and stuff. It's not just stand there and attack.
When things get hard, just give up.
Yep. Dash in.
So before you repair your weapons, definitely identify some of the other ones first.
I got your identification right here.
I wouldn't recommend identifying the bronze ones if you don't have a lot of money.
Yeah, I don't know if I was playing on a high difficulty or what with Asura's Wrath, but no, this one boss, and again, it's either chapter 15 or slightly after that, was just way too hard. That's towards the end of the game.
So one kind of nice thing also with this, as far as your weapons are concerned, whether they're 100% or, you know, 50% durability, they sell for the same amount of money. So you don't have to worry about repairing before you sell them.
Oh, that's nice.
Quests. Oh, they've got more quests to give. Ooh, squid nigiri. I would eat that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not saying I would like it, but I would eat it. Alright.
You're getting swords and spears from that game, like, I'm not a...
Yeah, you're right, it's not, Tyler.
Yeah, there's like a whole complex crafting system. That's interesting.
Give it up, Adam. You've lost.
Yeah, Adam. No, I'm not following you, lady. Yoshitsune, she's the second AI partner whom I got a little while ago.
The classes don't matter so much, Bob Jones. They just kind of dictate your starting stats, from what I've seen. Your weapon, pretty much.
Yeah, I mean, as far as actual abilities, the abilities are connected to the weapon, so... Yeah, it's pretty much the starting stats pretty much are just for what type of weapons you want to use, and that's pretty much it.
And your weapons change a lot depending on how you enhance them. Your weapons can become pretty powerful if you put enough resources into them.
Well, that's handy.
Yeah, like I've got some really strong weapons now that kind of
can partner items. Quest clear.
Is there product endorsement other than the game this evening?
Yes, Miller Lite.
Code Zero?
My stream.
We gotta get some of that sweet Coke money. Wait, that didn't come out right.
We're not giving out codes tonight if that's what you're asking.
Yeah, because the code wouldn't do you any good right now.
Yeah, as I understand, you can already download this even without a download code in English. You can download it, you just can't actually get onto the server. Alright, come on.
Yeah, you can always follow all of us. We all stream to a degree.
Please do.
To one degree or another.
We would all love that. Free swag. Okay, now I'm going to do that identification we talked about. I just had to go... You have all these things you have to do at the beginning of the game, learning the different systems and stuff, and yeah, that is taking up a little bit of time. Identify. Here we go. So, just identify everything I ever get?
Yep. I mean, unless it says that it's like a really crappy thing, then don't waste the money on it.
At the start of the game, well, once you get the guy where you can sell stuff, you can sell it for more than you would it would be if you identified it and then sold it.
Hmm.
Because it costs usually like over 100 to identify something, and you only sell it for like 50, maybe.
Ooh, jeez.
Yeah.
So I'm getting some different swords here. Ooh, a bow. Finally, I will have a bow. Ooh, and this one said success.
But if you get the artisan's treasure sword? Do not sell it or break it down or anything. It's
a great
really
success. It's a golden sword.
Wow.
Munchy Munchy.
You will get a lot of golden swords. And you want to save duplicates if it's a weapon that you're going to actually use.
Just for when one wears out or for a different reason?
Once the weapon gets to level 10, you have to use another version of the weapon as material to craft it to the next level. So you can start crafting it to like 11 to 20.
Ah, that's good to know.
Be perfectly honest though, I mean, we're jumping levels so fast that I don't know if it's worth worrying about at this point.
Yeah, I didn't do it until I got like a level 30 something weapon.
You gonna try out YouTube gaming, so-called?
So I've considered trying YouTube, but believe it or not, there's already a little kid who has either the same name or close to it enough that it might get confusing to people. So I don't know. I might leave YouTube alone for now.
Oh, plus, YouTube by a child.
Yeah, well, I'm not an evil old man trying to knock children out.
I got a sword called Onigiri.
Yep.
Which means Demon Slayer. Or Ogre Slayer.
Plus, really? Hitbox is really nice to the streamers.
I hear that. Unlike...
So,
their features are pretty nice.
Yeah, and they're now everyone can partner. So everyone
that
can earn money.
Cool.
I mean, they kind of have to try to get people to go there, but... Bob Jones, there are archers.
Yeah, I just got bows.
All you have to do is equip a bow, and ta-da, you're an archer.
Free swag, repair fairy.
Yep.
Oh, and now she's got another quest for me.
I'm not so big on the YouTube myself, simply for the fact that they can stop your stream at any time without any word or warning. If their content ID matches something that you're streaming, they immediately kill your stream.
Yeah, I much prefer the idea of, you know, being allowed to play whatever you want, and then if you know have some copyright issues, your stream just goes mute.
Well, in Twitch, that'll only happen on the replays.
Yeah, that's what
highlights.
I mean, during the replay.
During your stream, they're not going to kill your stream.
Yeah.
In the middle of it. That's just a silly rule.
Would you give me, it's the one that's closer to me, pull it again.
So if you get a lucky box, check underneath your currency, and you can click on it.
Am I muted?
Open it.
Okay.
No, you're not.
All right. By the way, here is the clothing guy. He's kind of, I believe he is supposed to be kind of a gay stereotype character, which is not wonderful, but again, this is kind of a common character trope in Japan. They're at a different place than we are as far as gay representation.
I don't know if I got that from this guy at all.
Yeah, I don't know if I got that from this guy. He just looks like some sort of
no,
weird,
it's from the
crazy
it's
monster.
From the dialogue,
really
not the appearance.
Gave you
the
that
dialogue
impression.
when you first meet him. He's like, it's fabulous, blah blah blah. You know, it's like every little thing a stereotype gay guy would say who's into fashion and stuff.
I think when you first start, all he has are sort of like your starting clothes that you can like just switch between the other ones. It's not really anything special yet.
Not yet. But all this stuff you can buy with Ryo, which is the soft currency, just the regular gold that you earn when you play. You can also change your character's physical features if you want, it looks like.
And you can actually change them more than when you're making
a
character.
Well, that's kind of weird.
You can change the saturation, the hue, and brightness, I believe, of your hair color and eye color.
Yeah, Tyler, they weren't on
shiitake
any mushrooms.
Mushrooms.
That's just... Japan.
Yeah, he's my buddy.
They were on shiitakes. Crazy.
He's nothing compared to some of the characters you're gonna see later. There's some pretty crazy ones.
I'm gonna go pick up this quest, and then we should run to that other town. It's saying to go to the next town. Oh, here's that. Is this the invisible guy you were talking about, so-called, where it's actually a tiny little guy?
So yeah, he's actually super freaking tiny.
Yeah, I saw that guy over here.
Yeah.
This, and they created this guy before Ant-Man. No. Before the Ant-Man movie came out, anyway.
I mean, seriously, how can you see that guy? It's just not even fair.
His name is Mini Musha. How cute. I wonder if in Japan his name was probably Chibi Musha. Chibi means they use for tiny.
At best, he looks like a little poo on the sidewalk. That's about it.
Yeah, you'll probably have to start over in the US because they're using different servers.
Yeah.
So if you plan on picking this up for the US, then yeah, you'll have to start over most likely.
But at least some of your, I mean, your achievements will carry over that you've already earned, so you don't have to do them again, which is handy unless you wanted to do them again, which some achievement hunters would want to do. But for others, it will be cool.
But I did have a problem registering with my email that I used when I tried the Japanese account, so there's some might be some kind of connection there.
Interesting. I was able to back in the day, you know, December last year when the Japanese version came out.
Yeah, if I had to use a... Well, I did create a character then.
There's another quest.
If I barely played it, then it wouldn't let me use the same account.
That's not good. Okay, I'm going to go pick...
Or they wouldn't let me register with the same email, so I'm like, well, maybe the accounts are connected.
Fusako, the used bookseller. One day, she'll be as big as Amazon.
Wait, where is she at?
Yeah.
She's in town.
Yeah, you get a quest from her, I think.
Does she have my name?
Your name? No, Fusako.
Oh, I think that his talk.
Has anyone actually walked through the entire town? Because it looks pretty big, but... I've been just chasing quests, so I haven't explored it.
There's a quest where you have to like go around finding like,
the little children. That pretty much takes you through the whole town. It's decent sized. It's not huge.
Yeah, it's not very big.
I think it's a little bit too big for what's in it, though.
Maybe
there needs to be a lot more NPCs.
Say the Destiny, you know, town.
Except this game has like 10 times the content.
And it's free.
Yeah. And it's free, yeah. That's
and
it's
free.
I think I almost have more time played than this in Destiny already.
And there's no console locked DLC.
Yeah, where if you want to dance, you won't have to give them $50.
Yeah, that was ridiculous. Let me go turn in this quest, and then I will be ready to go if you guys are ready.
Yep. Be careful with that giant crystal. If you walk into it, it will teleport to you automatically.
Yeah, Tyler, we talked about that. Yeah. As we said, it is like an early to mid-generation 360 or PlayStation 3 game graphically, and that is just because that's when the PC game came out. And again, PC MMOs tend to go weak on the graphics so that more people can run them.
And they tend to last many, many years, so the graphics don't get upgraded too much.
And also, if you think about it, almost all MMOs are not high-end graphic games because when places are full, you have a lot of characters on one screen, and that's very hard on the system.
Yeah, you could have over 100 other people on screen at one time for some of the bigger ones. Final Fantasy XIV, I would say, is probably the best graphic fidelity MMO I've played.
It looks that way.
Although Elder Scrolls Online probably... gives it a run for its money.
Yeah, Elder Scrolls Online looks good, although not as good as you would expect from like a non-MMO Elder Scrolls game.
Yeah, I don't know. The Elder non-MMO ones are a little rough without using mods.
I haven't played them, so I don't know.
See, Griffiths, I could see how you say the enemies look like they're from Power Rangers. Some of them, I said, look like they come from Sesame Street.
Yeah, we're going to be seeing some Sesame Street.
Yeah, just remember, they're all drawing on different forms of Japanese mythology, and Power Rangers and other Japanese shows like that do as well. So you will see some similarities here and there. So which way? It looks like we're going towards this way, and somebody's already running ahead.
Left.
You coming, Ethan? We're going to the next town.
Hey, Ethan's got some cool looking stuff. I don't know.
He got a ticket and used the gacha. The, you know.
Yeah, I have some tickets, but I don't know where
you I will tell you when we get there. Or when I get through this gate anyway. Oh, there's a new kind of enemy. Was that a kappa?
Yep, those are kappas.
Yeah, Icky,
you can tell they have the little bald spot.
Yeah, they're neat.
Final Fantasy 14 is pretty graphic taxing.
It is. I'll tell you, it's intense if you want to turn everything up.
It brings my computer to a crawl when I use all three monitors and in town. My computer starts to hate me.
They do a good job of having a you can play it on pretty low graphics and still.
Yeah, if you turn it down, you can still play it, but it's pretty intense if you try to turn everything up.
Yeah, they have a little bit too much detail in that game.
There is never too much detail.
I have,
but you just gotta remember that's something that MMO developers have to consider and work around.
That's true, but they do have a benchmarking tool. That way you can get a good sense as to what your system can handle.
Here, if Paul's in our group right here with the three of us, there's gonna be a really cool guy right up here.
The really tall one?
Yeah, he's my buddy.
The orange guy? Wow, that guy's huge.
Yeah.
He's a bad guy?
Yep.
Ah. What level is he?
Where is everybody?
We're over by the giant pink tree. You know, we're on our way to the next town.
Yep. We're right outside where you meet the cat mask guy.
Got him.
Yeah, he dies really fast, but he's cool.
Yeah, not that he was much of a challenge. I figured
it's he'd
probably
be
a
fox mask.
Yeah, there's some of the Sesame Street guys, like their eyes are really...
They look like they have googly eyes.
Yeah, they do.
Waka Flocka Flames.
I'd like to see what these are based off of.
I feel like if Seagriffus is asking a question, he's not serious about it, so I shouldn't give him a proper answer. Or attempt to answer.
No, I think he's just been trying to troll us all night.
Seagriffus, I'm gonna punch you in the nuts later.
Is that not a... That's a Muppets reference, isn't it?
Oh, it could be. But he said Waka Flocka. Yeah. So I don't even know what that means.
I haven't watched Muppets.
You're messing up the Fozzie Bear reference there, man. Come on, get it right.
During my recent trip to Europe, there were several other journalists there as well, and I haven't really talked about it very much. And in fact, I really shouldn't talk about it very much, but I want to briefly say that one of the guys there was from Pocket Gamer, and he's a British guy. You know, Pocket Gamer is based out of the UK, although they're not all located in the UK. But this guy was, and you know, I really enjoyed his voice and accent because I get a big kick out of certain accents, you know. As long as they're not running help desk when you call. Of course, no, to get a British person when you're calling the help desk, that would be pretty amazing, wouldn't it? But that would never happen. Not in this world.
That was a little bit of a low blow.
Well, no, I'm just saying, you know, I mean, everyone who...
No, you're lightly. Fully justified.
Yeah, you want somebody who speaks your language as their first language, not as a second language, when you're calling for tech support. And I'm sure we all feel that way. But anyway, yeah, so there was this British guy from Pocket Gamer there, and he was the definition of the word cheeky. Like, you know, like, all I can say is that he intentionally trolled me repeatedly throughout the trip. Although in his defense, we were all drinking quite a lot, and you know, like you're.
Yeah, but he'd be the expert, man.
Well, certainly, and he's kind of a bigger guy. Not. I would not say fat, you know, but just bigger, you know, taller and a little more muscular than me. But I would just.
When he trolled you, did he have that British humor?
Dude. Speaking of him trolling and British humor, I kept trying to get him to admit that Monty Python is an important and influential show, and he would not do it. Like, he kept talking smack about it. Like, he was really being antagonistic on purpose, deliberately, you know? And, like...
We're pretty much like Tyler.
Almost the exact same thing. But, no. You know, there's nowhere for me to really go with this story where I could, like, not be mudslinging or anything. But I will just say he was very cheeky. You know, like, the word cheeky is a British word, and it was invented for this guy.
All right, so what are we headed to?
This town. Follow me. Yellow Arrow. Yeah, I need to heal anyway. Who loves orange soda, ex-hobo? Oh. Kel from Kenan and Kel. Gabe. Alright. We're going to Kigaihara, is that what it said?
I was about to say before stream that you're going to be only one to pronounce Japanese names.
Yeah.
I'm not even going to try.
You guys, by the way, this is a fox mask, not a cat mask. It's a traditional Japanese thing.
Kitsune mask.
You sure it's not cat
Bob,
mask?
What does the fox say?
No, it's a fox mask.
Well,
don't even start that.
You give him gifts, he likes goldfish. He likes the same stuff that the cat likes.
Well, yeah, foxes eat that stuff. His name is Miroku. Miroku is how you would say that. Is there any beer in the game? I don't know. I'm drinking it, though. Are you still drinking, yep. Bob?
There is liquor in the game.
There's quite a bit.
Like that one, my first partner, she is an alcoholic.
Yes.
She talks about
the
how
princess?
She loves drink. No, not
Yoshitsune.
The big, big boob lady.
Yeah, yeah, just got a level talking to these people.
Tyler, you're getting punched later, man. They just had a little bit of a punctuation error there. They did not have a space after a punctuation mark. Oh, no, there too. They need to hire me as a copy editor, dude. I would not let that happen.
In all fairness, I gotta imagine translating an entire game of text without making a single mistake.
Yeah, a role-playing game, just all on your own. But, yeah, it also could be an issue of the bilingual person translating, you know, just isn't familiar with that particular rule. Because I saw the error multiple times, but then other times I'm not seeing it. So I guess it really is just a mistake.
And also for the fact that, you know, depending on what version of English they're doing.
Well, I think we all...
Depending on what rules.
Well, I think that's a rule that we all abide by, is that you do a space after punctuation.
Well, I'm just saying in general.
Kasumi the Traveler, let's see what she's got to say.
Some people want two spaces.
Yeah,
those
people are crazy.
Maybe it's just a little bug that they haven't worked out yet.
No, it's very minor. You know, I'm a big copy editor guy, so I'm always picking apart what people type. Like when Tyler talks to me in that teenager text speak. Oh, Tyler. That's all you can really say. Or when he starts typing invertedly, you know, because he's all inverted.
Should I add someone called Madam Coconut to my Skype?
I would not.
Madam Coconut.
Can I have some quests?
I must say yes and see where that goes.
No, not even close.
If it was a...
Maybe it's a robot and she'll
talk
to you.
Yeah, no, if it was a real person, then I would, just in the spirit of adventure, say yes. However, it is 99% likely to be a bot.
Yeah.
I actually talked to this one really impressive... Craigslist bot last month.
Nice.
It's actually impressive how well it adjusted for different questions.
Was it trying to sell
a
couch?
Deal?
No, it was actually trying to get me to accept a money order.
Oh, isn't that fun?
Yeah.
And then wire it back the money?
No, just... Oh, I forget. I was selling something or trying to sell something.
Okay.
Speaking of AI, I recently purchased and watched the movie Ex Machina. Have any of you guys heard of that?
Ooh, such a
good movie.
Actually
saw that.
Sweet. What'd you think of it?
I actually liked it. I thought it was pretty good overall.
I thought it was very good.
I loved it too. You know, I was not... We're not going to talk about what the ending is, but I was not especially happy with the ending. And it's a subject of debate. You know, like...
I thought the ending was very fitting.
Hey, have a good night, Mongbox.
We'll miss you, Mongbox. Yeah, great seeing you. She is the best.
Yeah, I would say what I liked about the movie is you could actually connect with the characters in that.
See,
yeah, you're right about that. They were very identifiable and well-developed.
And that is the exact opposite of the new Hitman movie that I just
saw. Is that
saw.
A fact?
That was a horrendous...
Hey, Ace Black.
Yo, Ace Black, good to see you.
Oh, I'm sorry apparently to hear playing that. Gears and Jeff. Chatting with us at the same time.
Well, he's a good man for coming along, you know. We appreciate you guys lending your support, even if you have something else to do at the same time. That is still always appreciated. All right, I have completed... I've turned in all my quest stuff, so we can leave this area if you want, guys.
Have a good one.
So
Ex-Hobo
apparently is in Scotland.
Is Ex-Hobo leaving? Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he's
hey, it was really
there.
Nice meeting you, Ex-Hobo. I hope you followed us. And please also follow my other Twitch channel. Well, Tyler, will you please type out my Twitch URL so Ex-Hobo can follow if he wants? Because, you know, usually when we do a midweek stream like this, we would be streaming from my personal channel and not from the Windows Central channel. We just did the Windows Central channel because this is kind of a big stream for us, and we wanted everyone to know that it's official. No worries, Ace Black. No, if we're going to give anybody heck for not being here lately, it's Derekuda.
What?
No, I mean, you're here today, but yeah, you need to come around more, man.
Ah, yeah. I'm sorry.
I'd blame Adam more.
No, well, Adam has his excuses, you know.
I've been busy trying to buy a house, so...
Weren't you between jobs? Or did you...
Yeah, that too. Yeah. There's a lot going on.
That's a tough time to buy a house.
Exactly.
So are we heading to the next...
Thanks, Ex-Hobo. It's really nice to meet you.
Stop shooting me.
Let me finish this dialogue session, and then I'll try to figure out where it's pointing me. If there's another dungeon around here, we should just go do it. I'm down for a dungeon if you guys are.
There's a bunch of dungeons around here.
Yeah, there's one we have to do for the story, I believe.
Okay, well, me and Derekuda are out here.
I'm killing the puppet-looking guys.
Wait, did you get out
of
the
rest
area? Yeah,
we just walked out of the rest area. We're right outside of it.
Oh. Heading that way.
For your main quest, does it say clear the forest?
Adios, Sex-Hobo.
Yeah, that's the
Bob Jones, I noticed that, and I'm glad to have you back, dude, just all on your own. It was really cool of you to come. And we understand, sometimes you have busy periods in your life, you know? We all do. It's as long as you come back, and, you know, not just a one-time come back, but, like, you basically try to come when you can. That's how we know you're still a part of our community, and we appreciate that. Because I like to, you know, we've cultivated this community for almost a year now, and we have a lot of really cool people here. You know, we've lost some people. But a lot of great people do stick around and come around as much as they can, and it's just so much fun to chat with you guys and to see you all every week. So I hope you all still feel the same way. So are you going to lead the way, so-called? I believe you should.
I have no idea where we're wanting to go.
Yeah,
just to the nearest dungeon, any dungeon that we haven't done before.
They Brian should lead the way.
Alright, I'll just walk then.
But you do know where one is? If you don't know where one is, let somebody who does...
I assume there's one this way somewhere.
Yeah.
You
are a cool person, Secret.
Hey,
that's
there's
right.
One.
Hey, Light Cycle.
Light Cycle!
To play
oh,
in
I'm glad
mode?
You made it. Are we gonna what?
Don't know. Gonna see what level normal is.
Because I'm only level 13. Oh, and I need to heal badly, so let me do that.
Actually, you know what? Hard is 12, hell is 19. I say we do 19
right.
With five of us.
They scale, remember.
Yeah, I know. I think we're good on hell,
well,
though.
Yeah, I mean, with some of these guys, we are.
None of us are... Everyone is over hard, so we might as well do hell.
Oh, I suppose. Let's give it a shot.
It's a lot of experience.
Yeah, just make sure you're a little bit more careful on getting hit this time
I'll
around.
Let you guys lead the way on this. I can see a team of bad guys down there.
Oh, please tell us about it, CG Griffiths.
This one does not have a boss, so this is a good one to try and help.
Bob Jones says we should have stuck to easy, but... So-called thinks he can handle it, we're letting him handle it.
There are a ton of enemies on this
let me
one.
Change to bow. Don't I have a bow somewhere? Oh, I think actually... I haven't equipped it, so I don't have one.
Yeah,
they're level 27.
You're 27, we need to get out of here.
Yeah. I'm probably gonna die.
The whole level scaling thing kinda.
I don't think you can get out.
We're trapped! Just let so-called kill everybody.
You just go, bring up the menu with start and then go to leave dungeon.
Oh, yeah. Okay. If you insist.
Oh, you guys.
You get 10 free revives per day, you guys, which is very similar to Warframe. I think Warframe is 3 or 5 revives per day.
But you also get to use the eggs, and they give you a ton of eggs.
Where is the leave dungeon? I don't see that.
Top right.
Yeah, it's right next to the logout.
Yeah, you were right, Bob Jones. You called it. Yo, Sniper Ski, welcome to the stream.
Sniper Ski.
Oh boy.
Ski.
All right, let's do this one on hard.
The after-hours stream starting up.
Yeah. By the way, we're going for another 45 minutes stream-wise, you guys. We promised a 2-hour stream tonight,
Nosy.
And so that's what we're doing. Welcome, Nosy.
Oh yeah, this one's a lot more.
Nosy says,
Light Cycle,
free,
what's up?
3 free revives on PC.
Yeah, 16. That's a little closer.
All right. Hard it is.
Yeah, we're only 16 on hard.
See, Griffith says he's glad that things are not using Flash anymore. Oh.
I don't think Flash will ever go away entirely, because there's always going to be legacy stuff that people aren't going to bother reprogramming for HTML5 or anything else.
And then they will die
off.
They will, but
Adobe dropped the ball with Flash. You know, they bought Macromedia, and they are the shepherds of Flash, and they've allowed it to continue to be this vulnerable, resource-hogging thing, whereas they could have fixed it up, you know, but instead...
Well, there's no money to be made of it, so that's why. People don't have to buy it, so...
It's a shame.
Adobe doesn't bother.
But, I mean, if you remember, you know, the early days of the internet, we talked about this on our previous stream, but Flash was so important to the early days of the internet, and it really improved the internet experience in dramatic ways, you know, from gaming to videos and animations. And
Shockwave.
Yeah, exactly, that too. And it's just such a shame to see that it has become this bad thing over time. But at least there is HTML5 and stuff like that, so that we don't need it.
I mean, there are some amazing HTML5 applications.
It's pretty stunning what you can do with it. And a little JavaScript.
How I wish I had stuck with programming, guys. That was my original intention career-wise. Because it was fun.
But then you wouldn't be doing these awesome streams.
Yeah, no, and I wouldn't have gotten to go to Riga last week as a journalist, and that would have been a shame. And I would miss the groupies, obviously.
You better bite your tongue.
We would all miss the groupies.
Oh yeah, totally. There's groupies everywhere.
QuickTime is officially dead, right?
No, not if you own a Mac.
Oh, they don't even advertise it on their website anymore, I thought.
So that must mean they're totally ashamed of it now, just like iTunes.
Isn't QuickTime more like a media player now than it is an actual
extension
file format and all
that? MP4 all the way.
Well, QuickTime MOVs are just MP4s in a different container.
But what I really hate about using QuickTime or any Apple software product is that it pesters you about updates like practically daily, or really weekly, I think, but way too often. You know, it's just a nag and a way for them to try to, I assume, a way for them to try to put, like, advertising software on your computer, whatever. But it's obnoxious. That's why I just will not run Apple software if I can avoid it.
They're trying to fill all those gaping security holes.
Maybe that's
everyone.
It, yeah.
Speaking of updates, are you using Windows 10 yet?
I am on my Surface Pro, but not on my notebook, because stability is very important for my notebook.
I have to say, if you're worried about stuff like streaming on your notebook, I've had zero issues streaming on Windows 10.
That's good.
I did when it was still beta, but that was just because my computer kept locking up.
Yeah, your computer could be crashing a lot.
I actually haven't had any of those
issues.
I was having problems until I updated my Intel Rapid Storage whatever thing drivers. I was just getting black screen restarts. Apparently I'm on fire.
Yeah,
Lightcycle says he has to use a Mac for work, and he does not enjoy that.
I actually, I have a MacBook Air. I actually like the computer.
Bleh.
I have a confession. I used to be a Mac guy for like 7 or 8 years, so I have no qualms about them. I still like them, but...
Alright, Tyler, make sure you ban.
It's just, you know, it's the whole thing of... the whole being overpriced for what it is thing that, you know, Apple owns proudly.
Yeah, but if you think about it, and it sounds like I'm defending them, so it's kind of bad, but if you think about it, the Ultrabooks in general really started becoming the same price as, like, MacBook Airs and things like that.
Well, for much higher specs, though.
Yeah.
Typically, they have a lot higher specs.
Sometimes.
Like Dell's little 13-inch XPS, that thing will run circles around even some of the MacBook Pros.
Ew. Whoa, this is new. I'm not used to this, the scaling. This is
Tyler
spooky.
Is speaking in an inverted fashion.
Yeah, these guys normally aren't here.
Oh, this is scary.
Oh,
I
that
don't
hurt.
Let those guys slam you, because they'll kill you one shot.
Yeah.
That hurt. Dodge them easily. Because when there's a lot of them, though.
As far as tech's concerned, I mean, I have a little bit from everybody, so.
Yeah, it's good to be platform agnostic. No, you know, like, I mean, when I complain about Apple, you know, we're complaining about the PC software, because, like I said, it's bad in some ways. And I complain about the overpricing of the hardware, but, you know, I would never say, hey, don't use an iPhone or whatever. No, because iPhone is a great gaming platform for mobile gaming.
Don't fall on me.
I might have to switch my other character, but I didn't know this was going to be so hard.
And
this one's not too bad. Just don't get hit.
Yeah.
Yeah, just watch them when they put their arms up.
You know, one of my favorite gaming sites is Video Gamer UK. I talk about them often enough, right? And they, like all of their guys, you know, like I take their opinions very seriously because I like them all very much, but they all strongly feel that it would not be a good idea to buy an Xbox One instead of a PlayStation 4. And, you know, it just makes me a little sad because, obviously, you know, the PlayStation 4 is more powerful and it has a little bit more in the way of downloadable indie titles. But still, there's nothing, you know, I mean, God, I'm saying you know too much again. I did that last stream.
You know?
God, don't you hate that when you notice you're just drawing on the same words over and over? One of the guys on the trip, he would always say, what was he saying? Like, to be fair or something. He would be like, to be fair. And he must have said it 300 times during that 3-day trip, you know. It's like, I wanted to point it out, but you can't do that because you have to be polite. Anyway, what was my point? Obviously, the Xbox One is a great system. It has the best fall exclusives this year, no question about it. You know, PlayStation 4 just doesn't have a lot in that. What is their Uncharted slipped, and they just didn't have anything else ready in time for this year. And their E3 presentation, it was all about games that are really far off. Because, again, they do not have any big software titles for the rest of the year.
Well, if someone asked me if they wanted, if they should get PS3 or Xbox One, I'd say, if you want to play something this year, Xbox One, next year, PS4.
Yeah, and for all we know, there will be a bunch of hot Xbox One stuff next year, too. How do we know there won't be? It's just Microsoft is focusing on the here and now because they have so much to in the here and now that's worthwhile.
Yeah, like, Sony has a ton of great stuff coming up, but...
Hey, I got an achievement.
Way to go! PlayStation 4 has the hardware advantage, and let's not discount that. It's nice to have that beefier hardware, but how many people here bought the PlayStation 2 over the original Xbox? Because the original Xbox was way better than the PlayStation 2, and yet I believe...
Significantly
better
hardware.
Yes, but I bet a lot of people in the audience, even if not on the mic right now, had a PlayStation 2 and not an original Xbox. You know, I mean...
Well, I had all of them, so...
I had a PlayStation 2 until the original Xbox broke, or until the PlayStation 2 broke, and then I got
I had them both, I mean, and the GameCube, but the GameCube and the original Xbox were my mains, and the PlayStation 2 was more for stuff I could only get on it. But, yeah.
My GameCube got abused. I never used it, ever.
It had so many good games, though.
I know.
Including
the
one
Xbox
of the best Dreamcast
two
games
took up all my time.
Sonic Adventure?
I got lost. Are you guys still by the cave?
I'm outside of the cave. I don't know where everyone else went.
I'm going to go ahead and switch characters because I need materials from these dungeons anyways. And there's no trade
system. Can't you have up to three characters? I could have sworn there was a trade system of some sort from a forum post I was reading a little while ago, but I don't know the details.
We kind of figure it out if there is.
It might a trade system. It might be obfuscated.
You can like set up a stall and sell stuff, but you can only sell stuff for real world.
Oh, it's the setting of the stalls.
Yeah, but you have to buy stuff from stalls using real money, like the paid currency.
So I guess without premium currency, there's no trading, which is a little bit of a rip.
Yeah. A little weird.
But I mean, I can't necessarily blame them considering it's a free-to-play game.
They gotta make their money somehow.
And so far, and maybe anyone else can speak to it as well, though, I have yet to feel like I'm being held back.
Yeah, I don't know if that's just because of the preview.
I think they're actually
it's not because of the preview.
Generous.
Yeah, because
I played the Japanese version a bunch.
Like,
I got farther than this, and it was.
I haven't had the grind at all, and it just feels so smooth so far.
That is a good thing. I'm sure when you get higher level, eventually it becomes necessary, but they certainly are very welcoming compared to some games.
And it's a great game that if you only have like 20, 30 minutes to throw down on, you can jump in, accomplish one or two things.
I found Paul, but I don't see the rest.
Yeah, I'm running back here to turn in a quest.
If you look at the minimap, you see all the little blue triangles.
Oh, I had to switch characters, so...
No, Light Cycle, I don't believe you can do that. It's not that kind of stall. It's more like a little ground-based booth like you would see in big cities here in the U.S.
Yeah, it's more like a little frog thing on the ground.
I have to agree, CG Griffiths. I think No Man's Sky is going to be disappointing.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, not me. I'm excited about it.
It's a cool premise.
I think you're going to be disappointed. It's going to be probably the same.
Yeah,
crap
everything
over and over
they've
again.
Shown, people keep talking about this. Everything they've shown looks very similar. It doesn't seem like there is that much different to do.
Well, I mean, just for stuff to be like creative. I mean, think about how big GTA is and how much effort they have to put in to make that world feel full and alive.
Yeah, and they're talking about building
an
entire galaxy.
Yeah, it's going to be extremely repetitive.
I'm still looking forward to hearing about it, you know? Like, it could end up surprising us. I hope so.
We should take this quest back and...
Yeah, I'm turning in a couple of quests in Onigashima myself. Ooh, congratulations on clearing a bunch of quests. That wording is kind of funny.
Yeah, I think every test quest to get that.
Going back to the Xbox PS4 debate, that's like my biggest issue is I want to play No Man's Sky with people, but all my friends are Xbox, and that's ultimately what made me like decide.
Yeah, that's
my console my platform of choice, really.
Yeah, that's the first thing I say when they ask it, say like, which one do more of your friends have, because that's more important than the actual games.
Yeah, I mean, I have both systems, and I can honestly say that at no point do I feel like I want to play one over the other based on graphics or something
that's
like
good.
That.
Yeah.
I mean,
it's more about your friends have.
Oh, I think the graphics are so minimal, like it
doesn't
even...
Yeah, people totally exaggerate.
I don't even see
a
difference.
Oh, this one's 900p, this one's 1080p, and real users will not notice that. It's only people who are very, very anal.
They're sitting 15 feet away from a TV, too.
Yeah, and it's kind of like something that I tell people when you're buying a television, you know. I sit there, look at 50 televisions, oh yeah, this one looks better than that one. If you bring pretty much any of those home... Really quickly, you're going to think that TV looks amazing, even if it looks so-so in store.
Wait,
it's just all based
TVs,
on comparison.
Are really iffy with games. It depends on the type of game, because there's, especially fighting games, you have to have certain TVs where you have
refresh rate, is that what you mean?
Yeah, but I'm talking about in general.
Because a lot of TVs, it depends on the type of TV, but there's some that have really bad display lag, and there's actually websites you can go to that show you.
That's true. There are some TVs that have very bad... Lab.
Yeah, like I know with Street Fighter V, they were testing it, or they were letting people play it at Six Flags, but the TVs there were really bad for them. Like, they were really nice TVs, but they were not for
playing games.
Yeah,
I call those plasma TVs, because...
No, I hear there's some TVs that have such bad lag that they don't even have Armika in them in Street Fighter V.
Oh no, I feel so bad for Street Fighter V now.
Dude, I always liked her a lot. Street Fighter Alpha 3 was fantastic in my opinion.
She's like a joke character.
Well, yeah,
though.
But she's fun. I mean, Zangief, he's a comedic character often, depending on how they interpret him.
I don't know, there's him or her and then... Birdie, they changed him, so he just looks like a complete
really?
Joke now.
I'll have to look that up, I haven't seen
Maybe.
Him.
Oh,
Birdie was always something of a joke character, though.
He's absolutely disgusting now.
I'm going...
Yeah, the chat's talking. I'd say I have to agree. Frames per second is bigger than actual resolution.
Yeah.
Like, most of the time, 720 and 1080p can look a lot alike. A lot alike.
Yeah.
If you get an extra 20 frames per second, it's most definitely worth it.
That's where the Xbox One sort of.
Can you guys come to the Kokujo Forest? I have a quest to do. I don't know what difficulty I'm supposed to do. I mean, it's a dungeon in the Kokujo Forest.
Usually it's just like, just complete it and there'll be like a boss or a drop from one of the
bosses. I could
do
it just on the lowest difficulty, but if somebody wanted to come along, that would be better. All right.
I'm coming. I have the same.
Well, you can start it too.
You're already level 16. Yeah, yeah. My God.
Well, because we all gain experience from each other.
I feel so screwed yesterday.
Poor guy.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. So me and So-Called, we played for like what 7 or 8 hours. It was really long, and we only got like level 12 because of the glitch.
Okay. I don't know what difficulty I'm supposed to do for the quest. Is the only thing.
It doesn't matter. It's
just
pick
one. Some quests do matter.
Yeah. Yeah, some quests do matter, but as long as it doesn't actually say in the...
All right, I picked normal, so let's just fly through normal. And then if we have to, we'll go up to the next difficulty. Right. But it'll be quick.
I'm in the town still. I'll be there shortly.
Yeah, frames are a pretty big deal if you're doing, like, fighting games.
Yeah.
I know, like, Street Fighter 4 and even 5, even though they said they weren't going to have them, there's some combos that require the exact input, like, within one frame.
So, Sniper Skeet, how do you like G-Sync? Been considering buying a G-Sync monitor or a whatever the AMD one is, FreeSync.
FreeSync, yeah. I would stick with the AMD one because it's an open standard.
Well, it's mostly open. It's open with a slight couple little twists, I think.
Huh.
If I remember correctly.
Nope, it's a fully open standard.
You sure? Because I'm pretty sure they... I mean, it's... fully compatible with the open standard, but I think AMD adds a little bit on top of it.
If I remember so.
I mean, I know NVIDIA's entirely their own gig, but...
Bob, you have two characters in the 30s, is that correct?
No, I have one that played 13, that or 16, that I was playing with you.
There's no official release date yet, Fujisaru's. I can't pronounce your name.
Other than that, I believe it's by the end of the year, no. Though.
You got too many syllables in your name, Isu. I'm just going to call him Isu.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah, we don't have an official...
we're playing this on Xbox One in English for anybody who's joining late. And it is going to officially launch soon. We just don't have that specific date yet. However, I can say that Windows Central will have the release date announcement before anyone else. We have exclusive rights to that.
Still really weird that we're the only 5 people on the server. Like, it was
I've seen some other people.
Just testers.
They're probably good.
Yeah, there's developers.
Like, yesterday, for like a couple hours, I was the only person. I was like, this is really weird.
As a special treat to the viewers watching, everyone watching today will be able to play it free.
There you go. It's a bonus just for tuning in.
That's a great way to sell it.
I was actually wondering where you're going with it. It's like, what is he about to say?
Yeah, I thought he was going to talk about, like, grabbing everyone's butts or something. But no, he went in a different direction. Alright.
I did not expect that.
So you're doing the forest on normal, you said?
On the easiest difficulty, whatever it is. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that's the, there's an interesting boss on that one.
Yeah, we're just kind of, like, flying through it.
Yeah, I'm about to join you guys.
The crab that Derekuda promised.
Crab
yeah,
with a mustache.
The giant we'll explain
crab.
This. In my preview, the preview that we published at Windows Central today, I mentioned that the Japanese version, when I played it, had this crab fight in the tutorial, the actual tutorial of the game. It is not in the tutorial of the English version that we're playing today. So, but it was also not in the English PC tutorial either back when I did that. So it seems to be either a regional difference or that the Japanese version was like a version behind or something and they eventually took him out of the tutorial.
Well, he's dead.
Yeah, he went down pretty quickly. He went down like Tyler on a hot dog. Tyler loves hot dogs.
Yeah, Sniper Skeet, I'd actually get one of those type of monitors if it wasn't for the fact that my video card currently doesn't support it. And if I get a new video card, that's another like $600 on top, so
It's only money.
That's the brand I would buy, though. Yeah, it's only money. I would buy NVIDIA over anything else because they always have the, or nearly always have the best performance or special features, but for the cost, it's a whole different story, obviously.
I've been
AMD's top cards are competing very well with NVIDIA. They're more power hungry, but as far as performance is concerned.
Well, they just announced the 290 or the 390 Fury, I think it was. They have it's a small card.
Oh, yeah.
That draws very little power.
It's supposedly really nice.
It looks
It'll
nice
fit
for
into your small
yeah,
cases.
Your ultra small form factor PCs. It looks pretty good.
It's just ever since Arkham Asylum had these exclusive NVIDIA features, and that continues to this day, you know, I guess because NVIDIA pays for it or helps out or whatever.
Most of that stuff was BS anyway.
Some good physics, dude, that you just wouldn't get if you weren't using it. Not important to the actual gameplay, but pretty neat if you get a kick out of those graphical things.
A buffalo chicken.
Yeah, Tyler, I was right. Tyler loves him some hot dogs. I'm going to go turn in this quest real quick in Kikaigahara rest area.
Yeah, so called's really easy to follow because it's a big box.
Good seeing you, Windork. Thank you for tuning in.
Am I supposed to be going somewhere right now?
No, you're supposed to be leading.
Yeah, you actually are the leader, so called. I'm turning in this quest to Miroku.
Yeah, that is a strange thing how that box kind of stays over his head.
Yeah, it does block some of the things.
See you, Windork. Don't forget to come back.
That's one of the things. If I was to communicate with the developer on a critical level and not just, by the way, these are the bugs we found, then I would say that there needs to be a way to turn off the party box.
Absolutely. Like, they just need a good party finder window, and that's good enough.
Agreed.
I had all the consoles from that generation, Icky. PS2, Dreamcast, GameCube, and Xbox.
Didn't you mostly play your Atari Lynx?
Oh yeah, totally.
I miss my Dreamcast. Aww.
I bought
one on eBay recently.
I did miss mine until I played Xbox 360 and all the Dreamcast games were like on there already.
They never did
release Skies of Arcadia on Xbox, even though it was certified.
That was on the GameCube.
But they were going to release it on the 360 along with Shenmue 1, and they just never did, and that is such a shame.
There had better be a re-release for Shenmue 1 and 2 before
you would
3
think,
comes
dude.
Out.
Oh, I mean, Sega would be leaving money on the...
I don't think
they
will.
I mean, they're already leaving money on the table, because obviously they ported it, or were in the porting process, and then just never published it, which is dumb.
I remember Shenmue was supposed to be like a 7-part series.
Yeah, and now...
So to get a third one is, I was like, that's great, but what happens to the rest of the...
Well, I think two, he condensed like 3 or 4 different chapters into one.
Yeah, part 3 is just going to wrap the whole story
up. And
that's how he's
condensing and having to shorten things a little bit.
The problem
from what
is
I understand.
It's been so long, I don't even remember like the story to number 2.
Oh, that's why they can...
I think with that game, a lot of people are living on memories compared to actually
nostalgia.
How good they felt
Shenmue,
the game was.
You mean?
Yeah.
Well, it was.
Well, I mean, Dreamcast
too.
I mean, I like Dreamcast, but some people act like it was like so ridiculous beyond everything else. But I mean, it was very solid. But it's not like
I mean the software lineup, dude. There were so few bad games to good games. The ratio was just great.
And I mean, I loved it. My first MMO was on Dreamcast.
Yeah, so
it holds a special place in my heart because I bought it on launch, and I remember saving up tons of money just so I could. Because you know, I was in school
still.
Dude,
I bought 2 of them on launch day, and I already had a Japanese one.
Wow.
I already had a Japanese one, which launched like in I don't know March of that year or sometime earlier. So I had Marvel vs. Capcom back when it was a big deal. Still in arcades, you know, I had the Japanese Marvel vs. Capcom at home, and I could just show that to friends, and they're like, oh my god! You know, because it was the only way you could play it at home.
They had a lot of arcade perfect.
Yes.
I believe.
Because that was the end of the golden age of arcade games, and the Dreamcast had all these wonderful arcade ports, especially from Capcom and Sega.
Well, the reason for that is, the big reason for that is because the machine that was in Sega's arcade cabinets was basically a Dreamcast.
That certainly helped.
So where are we?
You need to lead the way, so-called. Go pick a dungeon for us to do that we haven't done yet. Would be best.
Oh, I gotta come back out of town then.
Yeah.
Does anybody in the audience have any questions about Onigiri for consoles other than when it's coming out, or whether you can transfer your PC character? Because if you had any additional questions, we would be happy to talk about it for you, because obviously we've spent a decent amount of time with it, especially my friends here. Hey, look, some giant...
What's that? Can we do that one dungeon that you were so-called last night? That was only level 18, I think, right?
Yeah, was it this way? I can't remember.
That's right. You were playing in it for, like, what felt 2 hours? And
yeah, it was this way.
Frustrated.
I don't know if everyone will have access to it, but yeah, we'll try. Go this way.
Yeah,
I regret that I never had a Game Boy Micro, because that kind of thing is right up my alley. And I do have 50 or 60 Game Boy Advance games, most of which are still fantastic.
There is not English voice acting yet. So
yeah, no, it's going to be Japanese voice acting with English subtitles. That's just, it's part of the game's appeal. This game is meant for people who enjoy watching anime and things like that. Typically, they enjoy watching these things subtitled. And also, it's just a cost measure, you know. Because it's a bit of a niche title, because there's people who won't appreciate the older graphics, or there's people who won't appreciate the Japanese imagery and themes. And so you can't just go crazy and dub everything. That's the reason a lot of Tecmo Koei games, or it's Koei Tecmo, isn't it? A lot of those games have Japanese dialogue with English subtitles for the same reason.
Yes, the Japanese version will still work.
I was very surprised that EDF has full voiceovers. I was really surprised.
Yeah, so am I, actually. I thought with EDF 2 that they would not do that, but they are going to. The Vita one.
All right,
that's
I
really
see
niche.
Bob. Did I leave everyone else in the dust?
I was in town, so I don't know where anybody is.
All right, I'll come get you.
I think I might have gone the wrong direction. I'm turning in this quest in Onigashima. Dang it, I did go the wrong way. Let me turn in the quest real fast. All
right, I'll meet you guys at the town. Right outside
I'm at this
town.
Giant cave with a skull.
Yeah, that's where you should be.
Yeah.
I don't see you guys.
Sorry, I don't know how I lost you, man.
All right, I'll look for the cave.
I'm coming back to the town, so just stay there.
Yeah, I'll hang out here and wait for you guys to meet up.
That was a good
here.
Question, Bob Jones.
Does the Jap version still work if you're talking about this game? Yes.
The Japanese.
Yes, absolutely.
Version.
They're not going to turn off the Japanese version.
That's their moneymaker.
Well, actually, the Japanese Xbox One version, there are so few Xbox One sold in Japan. They released it in Japan first, because that's their native language, but their intention was always to bring it to English markets and make their money that way.
Yeah, I was talking more of PC,
there you go.
Though.
Yeah, PC, different story. Although, PC gaming is still not
strange.
That popular in Japan compared to America.
Alright, so I'm right outside town, so when you guys leave town...
I found Derek.
Yeah, everybody meet outside of Onigashima, the main town.
Only the people that don't know where to go.
There you go, yeah.
Yeah, we're going to that big cave with the skull and the screws and nails and chains.
Ah, there it is. Ooh, I don't know if I can get through. It looks like there's a barrier.
Alright, turned in my quest. Got some experience.
It says I have to do something first.
Alright.
If you want to proceed...
That's what I was worried about is you're high enough level probably, but you do have to go through the story.
You have to clear Kishiden.
Kishiden. We can't do it as a group.
Well, you just have to clear it with
Kishiden. Yeah, we go
clear
Kishiden. Which is in town.
Oh, yeah, that is in town.
On every difficulty or on a specific
difficulty? I think that's the next place I have to go. That's the next part of the quest, Paul.
I kind of want some sort of fast transport, because there's a lot of running.
There is
you
a
do,
fast
yeah. From town to town, there is a fast transport.
Yeah, it's that crystal thing, right? The floating crystal?
Yeah,
but you haven't gotten to the second town yet.
Yeah, once you get to the second town, you'll know. Trust me.
Well, hell, I'm gonna head back to town then. And
I think that place where they have to go is where you repair the weapon, like that place right up there.
right up where,
with where you first spawned, and there's the
It's right next to the girl with pink hair.
Yeah, it's like right there at the top of the stairs.
Oh yeah, yeah, at the main town. Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
It's just gonna take me a minute to get back there because I'm not
sounds like
there
a chick.
Anymore.
Yeah.
I don't know. Is it on the PS4 in Japan?
This, I would think so, but I don't know for a fact. But they're, I mean, it's going to launch in English markets almost the same time as the Xbox One version, so you would think so. Just can't say for a fact. Oh, thanks, Tyler. At least I don't sound like a girl.
I had heard that the PS4 wasn't selling very well over there.
Well,
either.
Compared to Xbox One, it's still selling a billion times better. But yeah, not selling to expectations.
Yeah, but compared to the Wii U and the handhelds?
They're not into their console games anymore?
Totally
really?
mobile
it's
and
handheld
and focused.
Phones, basically.
They're not MOBA focused?
I mean, they could be, but it would be on
that's
mobile.
That's South Korea.
Yeah, that's more Korea.
No, they like their Monster Hunter games.
I'd play more mobile games if they were better and not all microtransactions.
Dude, somebody in chat mentioned this earlier, the Vita. Just get a Vita and you can play all the games you want on the go and they're great. There's so many great games.
Yeah,
so
it's only $500 per 16 gigabyte card though.
Do you want to do the hard one?
God, yeah.
Story scene is going on and on.
I just skipped it, man. The text can't be that interesting.
Yeah, I started and it's a little interesting, but then it just goes on. Way
yeah,
too
I
long.
I mean, I like it, but just the fact that we're streaming and that I have other people waiting on me makes me not want to stick with it fully.
Well, I'm still running back to repair my stuff, so.
Ah, dang it, I forgot.
I'm gonna see what level these enemies are.
I jumped in the dungeon.
To Kishinden, I just accepted that quest, but now where are we going?
It's right behind him.
Oh, okay. And what am I picking? Just
hard.
Okay.
Hard.
Hard.
Hard, yeah. We're only like 18, I think.
You're 18.
Yeah, the hard is only like 14.
Yeah, the text is. Well, when you're inside, they're actually 18.
So, wait, you're going to hard level 14?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Not hell level 21.
No, thank you.
No, because they're going to be more like 30 if we did that.
Yeah, let's...
I forgot to repair one of my weapons.
Let's get
here.
Everyone built up a little, well, so-called. Right. It's not our fault that you and Westex skipped so far ahead.
MS release.
And Bob.
You're wanting some type of Xbox Surface, huh?
Why?
Not sure how that would work.
It would be nice if there was a real portable Xbox of some form, but I just don't believe it's ever going to happen.
I think if it's going to be anything, they're going to do that with Windows Phone, honestly.
It would have to be a phone because I just don't think there's enough money in mobile gaming.
As far if as your gaming. Name's not yeah. Nintendo. If your name's
well,
not Nintendo,
yeah,
it's not going to happen.
I think Sony with the Vita could have actually turned around a big profit. The problem is that they never really gave it their all in English markets. They never properly advertised it. They never aggressively adjusted its price like it would have required. You know, they just didn't do what it took. They didn't keep the AAA English native games coming. Yeah, there's still many wonderful games because all these Japanese games are being translated. You know, like how I just got One Piece Pirate Warriors 3. But unfortunately, for it to be a big success in North America, you need your Uncharted games to keep coming, not just the one. You have to keep them coming, you know, and other games like that.
I have to say, I'm absolutely in love with the streaming feature from Xbox to Windows.
That is cool.
That's how I'm playing this right now.
It works, yeah, me too. It works so well. That's how I stream all my Xbox games now.
I want that, but I want it for Windows 8, because I haven't really made the complete.
They're never
going to
do that.
10.
Yeah, just go straight to Windows 10. It's definitely good to do it.
But they're never going to do it for Windows 8, because this is a universal app, which are not really compatible with 8.
And even if it wasn't, they want you to get off Windows 8. So.
Yeah, they want everybody on 10. Yeah.
I'm one of the few that actually loves Windows 8.
Yeah, but I mean, Windows 8 is not a step
I like
back.
Windows 8. I like Windows 8, but on desktop or laptop, Windows 10.
Oh, easily,
Not even close.
Oh, really? Yeah. Well, I tried to get it, but I guess it's good. Hurt, so.
It's definitely easier to use.
Good job, team. Yeah, that's actually not a bad idea. Sniper Skeet is saying the Surface should just have a built-in wireless adapter for Xbox One controllers, and that would be pretty clever. Like, why shouldn't that be built in?
It would be good.
Microsoft needs to capitalize on the goodwill that they already have for Xbox by doing that.
But the problem it's going to be integrated graphics, so you could stream.
Has anybody purchased the Hapalog TV tuner yet?
No,
Hapalog,
I haven't.
Is it a Hapalog or something?
Yeah, I don't know how you pronounce it.
Word, right?
Oh.
Hoppage. That's how I would pronounce it.
Hey, Bob, you can stop showing off.
God, Bob. It's your showboat.
You're really dying, though.
Who's dying?
I'm not dying.
Oh, look at the health bar. We have to keep sleeping dead.
Go find it, Goron. The guy makes a silly sound while he talks.
Oh, I want to do my water attack in this room.
I wondered who was doing so much insane damage. I forgot Bob went and got his OP character.
Level.
Yeah.
I would absolutely love if Sony had their own stream to PC software, because right now I have to go through the Elgato.
Have you seen
that.
Their software for transferring save data back and forth from the Vita to PC, though? Some of the worst PC software ever created. It's embarrassing. I just cannot believe a professional company released software in that state.
I just haven't touched my Vita, it's just the memory cards.
Well, dude, you just have to make the investment and then you have your Vita. You only need to buy one big memory card and then you don't need it anymore.
But that's like half the price of what I paid for the Vita.
They go on sale sometimes. Like, there's been times when you could get a 64 gig card for around $75 if you caught the sale. And although...
Which is my point. I mean, the hardware is worth like $20 for the memory card, not 60,
maybe,
70, 80.
Maybe worth $20.
Well, I'm talking
about
general.
Probably cost Sony like $5 to make.
The system?
Well, I know, I'm talking just
or the card. Oh, yeah, no, obviously they're charging too much for the cards, but although they're also producing them in a much smaller quantity than anyone would produce an SD card or whatever, so that does make it cost more than the exact same SD card, because you're not making...
Yeah, not that much.
I would say the only thing unique about their cards is the packaging. The NAND and the controller in it are going to be the exact same as all SD cards and other rest.
I hate how companies always have like their own unique thing.
Yeah, it's...
Well, Sony's always done that, though. They've always done proprietary.
I know Apple does that, too, with their iPhones. They have like this weird charger that's on the... with anything else.
Unfortunately.
Well, given how much they charge, Tyler, they better be making a profit
And it is a bad thing. However, if you want to enjoy your Vita, you just have to get, I would say, at least a 32 gig card. You can live with a 16 if you don't play a whole lot of games, but...
I got a 16. I mean, it's fine for my PS TV.
Are there counterfeit Vita cards? No. Kind of like how there are counterfeit Apple accessories?
There honestly don't seem to be. And there's no... Sony didn't even license it. They could have at least let SanDisk or somebody make one. But they didn't. They are being greedy on this, and it is holding the system back in a way, because some people just really, you know, like so-called, just really take issue with it.
Yeah, I mean, I've literally put it down because after I filled up my memory card quickly, I was like, I'm not going to spend another... you know, $60, $70, $80 on a system that I paid like $140.
That makes the system itself a bad purchase.
Just to play.
It's just, you know, like, I mean, if you need, for instance, if you need two controllers to enjoy a system, then that's just something you have to keep in mind when you buy the system. With the Vita, you have to keep in mind, by the way, I'm going to have to buy a big memory card. It's going to cost kind of a lot.
Yeah,
or do
a lot
of memory management, which is never fun. Which I'm kind of experiencing that right now with the Xbox.
You can look for deals, or you can use, or just use retail cards. You know, if you use retail games. If the memory card issue really bugs you, you could just buy the games physically, and then you don't have to worry about it. Then again, you're paying like, you know, retail. Not that digital prices are even cheaper, really, unless they're on sale.
At least with the Xbox, I just plug in a 3 terabyte hard drive.
Yeah,
and
that
I'm good
is
to go.
Yeah, there's like you can use like a universal storage device.
Crap, my
again, that's an example of Sony failing to aggressively take care of the Vita and make sure that it's a success. You know, like, there's this obvious stumbling block there, and they just refuse to do anything about it. And that's what's holding the Vita back, not the Vita itself, because the Vita itself is simply the best portable hardware ever produced. You know, way better than even the new 3DS.
Icky says there's Chinese counterparts.
Really? We don't get those over here. I don't think.
Oh, wow.
Alright, this boss is kind of tough. When he jumps up, do not let him hit you.
Chief Dharma. Wow. And he's a stylized version of that monk I mentioned, because I was looking at some realistic paintings of the monk, and you can see the connection, but they're different.
I mean, even due to my OP attack, it didn't take out that much health, so...
And avoid the stuff he throws.
Run.
Yeah, that's the third part, too.
It chases you, by the way.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Ooh.
And just ignore the ads.
Yeah, the ads will just die from.
Ah, oh, crap! Jump! Oh, he didn't do it. Okay. Does he only hit you if he's facing you?
He only hits you if you're close to. Jumping won't really do anything, crap. But I usually back up.
Yeah, definitely, Tyler, you're right. Because Tyler loves the Vita almost as much as me, or just as much. And. Yeah, we would love for it to be a success. It's never going to be that kind of success in North America. It doesn't mean it's not worth getting, because there is enough software to justify it. But
oh yeah, there's... Well, if you like that kind of...
Japanese games and indie games, you got plenty of both, you know? And...
Hey, yeah. Did you see that on the Sony store they were selling the PlayStation TV for like
$20
today?
That's a great price.
Wow.
Yeah, it's just the PSTV by itself. You would still have to buy a real memory card and a controller, but... A lot of us already have a DualShock controller anyway.
Yeah, so you can use like a PSP controller.
PS3 or PS4.
PS4. I would use PS4 controller.
Some people say the PS4 controller actually, for some reason, has a little more lag with the system than the PS3 controller. I don't know if it's true or not, because it's not scientific, but that's what they say.
Is it wireless?
You can either plug them in via USB or use them wirelessly.
Am I not doing damage this
he's
guy?
He's got a lot of life still.
He's really I'm doing my really OP attack on him, and it's not really doing much.
Like, I'm not seeing the typical numbers that I normally do.
Huh.
Yeah, he's...
But his
really
life
strong.
Is down a bit.
Yeah. I'm trying. I don't know why he's...
I guess we're going to wrap up the stream after we complete this fight, you guys. Everybody who has stuck around the whole time, such as Tyler and Icky, are awesome. Even the people who showed up late, some great people amongst that crowd as well. Let's see... What is it? X uses healing?
There we go. Right.
Yeah, my life is really low. I gotta heal.
Yeah. I'm an attack that works well. Yeah, make sure you're not moving when you press X, or it kind of like...
It uses the item, but you don't get the benefit.
I don't think it uses the item, but it does do...
It does.
It does?
Yeah.
Okay. Healing.
Alright, I figured out an attack that he's weak against, I guess.
Thank goodness. Yeah, he's about to die. Good job, Bob.
Yeah, he's weak against
Welcome,
water.
Welcome, Cyberknight!
He's fire attack.
Yeah, we've mentioned this several times, but there is no official release date yet. However, we do know it's coming soon, and that we will have the official release date before anybody else.
Man.
Oh, yeah. We got a ton of experience, though. So.
I did level up.
Ooh, I'm up to level 17 now.
Me and Derek are handed.
I am so jealous of you guys right now.
Boy, leveling up?
Yeah.
You're ahead of us, man.
Well, because we played for so long yesterday.
Got nowhere.
Levels, yeah. You guys played for like 2 hours, you're already 17, 18.
Like, you don't know how many times I went from level 12 to level 14 to level 12 to level 13 to level 12.
Yeah, it was rough, but it was still fun though.
Yeah, it was fun. I mean, it was a good time. But
it would have been not better if we were actually getting levels.
This dude's smoking a peace pipe. That's something you wouldn't see in American games too often.
He is certainly smoking that thing for all it's worth.
I still remember I was watching one Popeye episode like the last maybe 4 years ago, and his smoking was edited.
Oh, that's messed up.
I about lost it. I was like, really?
daddy. He needs to smoke. That's what makes you strong.
I'm allocating some skill points.
Hey, glad to hear you enjoyed yourself, Light
yeah.
Cycle.
And I'm really glad you made it, man.
This game is crazy.
It's good to see you all outside of a Saturday. And by the way, would anyone like to know what we're streaming on Saturday?
Oh, you haven't said. What are we streaming?
I guess so.
Why not? Yeah, we're streaming a game that... an Xbox One game, and giving it out that is not even out yet. Yes.
Oh. It better not be Dear God.
No, that would be neat, though. I'm looking forward to that game. But no, we're streaming...
Well, that's...
Yeah, true. No, this Saturday, we are streaming Nightmares from the Deep, The Cursed Heart, for Xbox One.
Oh,
which is a port of a it's a port of a PC and mobile game from Artifacts Mundi, a Polish game developer. It's a hidden object puzzle adventure game, so it'll be the first hidden object game for Xbox One. It also has a pretty good Mahjong solitaire mode, you know, where you match the tiles.
Cool.
And yeah, I like it a lot. I played through it on PC and had a great time with it, and I'm glad that it'll be coming to console. I don't know how well it will work on console, but we will find that out in just a couple days. And the fact that you'll be able to win this game before it even releases is a pretty special thing. That's something we wanted to do with Payday 2, but it didn't work out because of the bugs, you'll remember.
Yeah, I'm sure if it does well, they're gonna bring a lot of more.
Yeah, because it's an engine thing, you know. Once you get the engine working, then it should be pretty simple to port all the other games.
Yeah.
Gamer Tag Cyber Knight says apparently there's old Bugs Bunny cartoons where they skip frames so Elmer Fudd isn't shooting his gun.
Aw, that's lame. I don't think they do that on the Blu-rays. As far as I know, the Looney Tunes Blu-rays that exist are accurate in preserving what the cartoons were like. I could be wrong, but...
Yeah, I have some of the DVDs. They're all good.
That's good. Yeah, they're just...
Does Boomerang still show a lot of old Looney Tunes?
That's a good question. I haven't watched Boomerang in a long time.
I don't watch cable TV. So are we wrapping up?
We are. Yeah, Brian, didn't you say you only really watch lesbian porn nowadays?
Oh yeah, totally.
Yeah, I can't say I really blame you.
But, I mean, who could?
Who could?
Whoa.
Alright, I will accept this quest. Yeah, and we are gonna call it a night as far as streaming goes. We could keep around playing. We just need to wrap the stream. I mean, anyone who wants to keep playing, I believe we could continue playing a little longer.
I gotta get ready for bed. Work comes early in the morning.
Apparently it does.
For about another 10 hours.
I'm the furthest one east, I think, of all of us.
Excuse me, I am the east-exiest. Oh, that's a different thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, thank you for joining us, Bob Jones. Bob Jones says he has to go to sleep.
Twitter.
Yeah, that's... So I will see you guys all on Saturday at the normal time, 8 p.m. Central. Once again, thank you all for joining us for this very special stream. Thank you for Cyberstep for providing the game to all of us. They had to go to a lot of trouble to let us all play this game before everyone else. And as a result, we've been able to give you some great preview coverage that I'm really proud of. So,
and thanks to Paul for giving us the opportunity.
I love you guys, man.
Absolutely.
So if I'm going to go places then, and I can take my friends along, then that's what I want to do.
Apparently it's 4 a.m. in Utah.
Oh, yeah.
So, I did not know that.
Tyler.
Just like Tyler has to
I guess time flies for those Mormons.
The Mormons just have their own complete different time zone for that one state only. That must be. You know, Mormons were a subject of conversation when I was in Riga. We had a nice little talking about Mormons and then about the Xenu worshippers. Wait, that is Mormons, right? No. You know, Scientologists as well.
Scientologists, yeah.
I don't know. A bunch of different subjects came up because we were all so drunk and we spent so much time together. All right, so thank you again, you guys, for helping make this stream a success. Everyone for watching. We'll see you all on Saturday. Don't forget to leave a comment on the article. Leave a comment on the preview for this game because, again, that shows Cyberstep and my bosses that you were interested and enjoyed what we did. And I believe that's it, isn't it? Say goodnight, everybody.
Good night.
Adios.
Good night.
And remember, don't hate, appreciate.